Tonight, I want to talk to you about the believer's authority.
අද රාත්‍රියේ මට කතා කරන්න අවශ්‍යයි අදේ ලිවන්තයාගේ ආධිපත්‍ය පිළිබඳව.
Are you hearing?
අපට ඇහෙනවද මේ?
The believer's authority.
අදේ ලිවන්තයාගේ ආධිපත්‍ය.
You know, it's not good enough for you to attend a service like this and have the desire to be healed. That's not good enough.
මේ වගේ දේව මේකට සහභාගී වෙලා මේ සුවය ලබන්නට ආශාව තිබීම පමණක් ප්‍රමාණවත් වන්නේ නැහැ.
Because there are Christians that get healed of one thing and die of another.
මොකද කිතුනෝ ඉන්නවා එක රේකින් සුවය ලැබලා තවත් දෙයකින් මිය යන අය.
You don't want that.
ඔබට ඒක අවශ්‍ය නැහැ.
What you need is for a man of God to give you the necessary keys and revelation so that you can get healed but also stay healthy. That's what you need.
දේව මනුෂ්‍යක ඔබට දිය යුතු දේ ඔබට අවශ්‍ය දේ තමයි ඔබට එළිදරව්වීමක් දෙන්න අවශ්‍යයි ඔබ සුවය ලබාගෙන සෞඛ්‍යයෙන් ගමන් කිරීම සඳහා.
See, there are people who only think of a gym when they put on weight.
සමහර මනුෂ්‍යයන් නෝ අය gym එකක් ගැන හිතන්නේ බර වැඩි වුණාම විතරයි.
Like that, lots of Christians think of a healing service when they are sick.
ඒ වගේම බොහෝ කිතුනෝන් සුවදේව මෙහෙයක් ගැන හිතන්නේ රෝගී වුණාම.
We need to up our revelation.
එනිසා අපගේ එළිදරව්වීම අප ඉහළ නම් වාගත.
Revelation becomes your limitation.
එළිදරව්වීම තමයි ඔබගේ සීමාව බවට පත්වන්නේ.
The extent of your revelation becomes the extent of your limitation.
ඔබගේ එළිදරව්වීමේ සීමාව තමයි ඔබගේ තියනව සීමාව බවට පත්වන්නේ.
So we have to come to a higher understanding, a level of understanding.
එනිසා අපි ඉහළ මට්ටමක තේරුම් ගැනීමක් වෙත පැමිණිය යුතුයි.
While I can get healed.
මට සුවය ලබන්න පුළුවන් අතරම
It's God's will for me to be healed.
දෙවියන් වහන්සේගේ කැමැත්ත තමයි මම සුවය ලබන්න.
I have to learn how I can use my authority as a Christian.
මට මම කිතුනෙක් ලෙස මගේ ආධිපත්‍ය පාවිච්චි කරන්නයි ඉගෙන ගත යුතුයි.
To live a victorious life in health.
නිරෝගීව ජයග්‍රහී ජීවිතයක් ගත කරන්න පිණිස.
Because the enemy can trouble your flesh.
මොකද සතුරාට පුළුවන් ඔබගේ මාංශයට බාධා කරන්න.
Your spirit is born again.
ඔබගේ ආත්මය නැවත උත්පාදනය ලැබුවා.
Your human spirit that's recreated doesn't even know that you are on earth.
ඔබගේ නැවත උත්පාදනය ලැබුවා වූ ආත්මය දන්නේ නැහැ අඩුමතරම ඔබ පොළවේද ඉන්නේ කියාවත්.
Because your human spirit is no longer human spirit, it's a divine spirit now that came from above. You are born from above.
මොකද ඔබගේ මනුෂ්‍ය ආත්මය තවදුරටත් එක මනුෂ්‍ය ආත්මයක් නෙවෙයි ඒක ඉහළින් පැමිණුණා වූ එක.
Your human spirit doesn't know the difference between heaven and earth.
එනිසා ඔබගේ මනුෂ්‍ය ආත්මය දන්නේ නැහැ පොළවේ සහ ස්වර්ගයේ වෙනස.
Because it's a recreated spirit.
මොකද ඒක නැවත නිර්මාණය කරපු
ආත්මයක්. But your flesh.
නමුත් ඔබගේ මාංශය.
Your body goes
ඔබගේ ශරීරය යම් යම් දේවල් වලින් ගමන් කරනවා.
So it's important.
එනිසා ඊට වැදගත්.
To let your flesh know.
ඔබේ මාංශයට දැනුම් දෙන්න.
The revelation that your spirit has.
ඔබේ ආත්මයට තිබෙනා වූ එළිදරව්වීම.
You know one reason why Christians take communion.
ඔබ දන්නවද කිතුනෝනේ ඇයි සුද්ධ භෝජනය
සහභාගී වෙන්නේ? When you take communion.
ඔබට සහභාගී
වෙන්න. You are telling the flesh.
ඔබේ මාංශයට ඔබ කියනවා.
Get the revelation that you are healed.
ඔබ සුවය ලැබුවා කියන එළිදරව්වීම ලබා ගන්න.
Your human spirit knows.
ඔබේ මනුෂ්‍ය ආත්මය දන්නවා.
But your flesh doesn't know.
නමුත් ඔබේ මාංශය ඒක දන්නේ නැහැ.
That's why your flesh tends to give you trouble.
ඒ නිසා තමයි ඔබේ මාංශය ඔබට ප්‍රශ්න ඇති කරන්නේ.
It gets
ඒකට උණ හැදෙනවා.
Doctors say you have this now.
වෛද්‍යවරු කියන මේක දැන ඔබට තිබෙනවා.
You have something else.
ඔබට වෙන දෙයක් තිබෙනවා.
So each time you fall ill, you can't look for a healing service.
ඔබට රෝගී වෙන හැම වෙලාවෙම සුවදේව මෙහෙයක් සොයාගෙන යන්න බෑ.
How many of you understand what I'm talking about?
ඔබට කීතරකට තේරෙනවද මා කියන දේ?
That's like I mean you can't do that.
ඒක ඔබට කරන්න බෑ.
You can participate in a healing service just to boost your faith by seeing others heal.
ඔබට සුවය දේව මේකට සහභාගී වෙලා අනිත් අය සුවය ලබන විදිය දැකලා ඇදහිලි ඉහළ නංවා ගන්න
පුළුවන්. You participate in a service like this to receive the word for yourself.
ඔබට මේ වචනය ලබා ගන්න පිණිස මේ වගේ දේව මේකට සහභාගී වෙන්න
පුළුවන්. But you come to a place where you're not in that healing service for yourself.
නමුත් ඔබ එන්න අවශ්‍යයි ඔබ උදෙසාම නොවේ ඔබ සුවය
දේව මේකට සහභාගී වෙලා ඉන්නේ. Because you learn the believer's authority.
මොකද ඔබ ඇදහිලිවන්තයාගේ ආධිපත්‍ය දැනගන්න අවශ්‍යයි.
What to do if your flesh puts you in trouble?
ඔබගේ මාංශය ඔබට කරදර කරනවා නම් මොකද ඔබ කළ යුත්තේ?
If the doctor gives you a bad report.
වෛද්‍යවරයා ඔබට අයහපත් වෛද්‍ය වාර්තාවක්
දුන්නොත්. Can you as a Christian do something about it?
ඔබ කිතුනෙක් ලෙස ඔබට යමක් කරන්න පුළුවන් දේ ගැන.
Are you hearing this?
ඔබට ඇහෙනවද මේක?
This is called the believer's authority.
මෙන්න මේකට තමයි කියන්නේ ඇදහිලිවන්තයාගේ ආධිපත්‍ය.
I don't want any global church member of our church to be beggarly.
Mama, ah, kemati ne apake goliya sabha paule samajika kisikene ki
yaadana patthana wada. I don't want anybody in our local church to act like beggars.
Apake deshiya sabhave kisikene ki yaachakek wage hasiranawata mama kemati ne.
God, please heal me.
Devi swamini karuna karma avasuwa karanna.
No, you are bigger than that.
Naha naha oba ita wada vishalaya.
Christ didn't die and rise again from the dead to get you to beg for your healing. No.
Swanse marane vindala navata nagitte obada suye udesa ayachana karanna nemei.
And in the next 15 minutes
ඊළඟ මිනිත්තු 15 දී
ගගනු put a foundation for the believer's authority in your life.
ඔබගේ ජීවිතයේ අධිලිවන්තයාගේ ආධිපත්‍ය කරේ අතිවාරමක් බව දන්නවා.
You will know what to do if your flesh puts you in trouble.
ඔබගේ මාංශය ඔබට කරදර කරනවා නම් ඔබ කරන්නේ මොකද්ද කියලා ඔබ දැනගන්න යනවා.
Next time there's a fever
ඊළඟ වතාවේ උණ හැදුනාම
you will not need to call the faith line.
ඔබට ඇවිල්ලා faith line එකට කතා කරන්න ඕනේ නැති වෙයි.
You will apply the believer's authority.
ඔබ ඒ අධිලවන්තයාගේ ආධිපත්‍ය අදාළ කරගන්න යනවා.
Okay? Now this is just to promote you to your next level.
මේ ඔබගේ ඊළඟ මට්ටමට බෝ උසස් කරන පිණිසයි.
Okay. So what are we talking about?
අපි මොනවා ගැන කතා කරන්නේ?
The believer's authority.
අධිලවන්තයාගේ ආධිපත්‍ය.
Acts chapter 1
ක්‍රියාපලවෙන පරිච්ඡේදයේ 1 සිට 3 දක්වා.
Thank you. Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Acts chapter 1. Thank you, Pastor. Acts chapter 1 verse 1 to 3. The former treaties have I made, O Theophilus, of all that Jesus began both to do and to teach. Verse number 2. Until the day in which Jesus was taken up. Listen. After that he through the Holy Spirit or the Holy Ghost had given commandments unto the apostles whom he had chosen. Verse number 3. If you can read together, it'll be good for you. To whom also he showed himself alive. Who is showing himself alive? Jesus showed himself alive after his passion by many infallible, that means undeniable proofs, being seen of them 40 days, speaking the things pertaining to the kingdom of God. Say 40 days. Say 40 days.
කියන දින 40ක්.
Everyone say 40 days.
හැමෝම කියන දින 40ක්.
Say Jesus taught for 40 days.
කියන යේසුස් වහන්සේ දින 40ක් ඉගැන්නුවා.
After he rose again from the dead.
උන්වහන්සේ මරණයෙන් උත්තරන පස්සේ
40 days.
දින 40ක්.
Jesus began to teach.
යේසුස් වහන්සේ උගන්වන්න පටන් ගත්තා.
His apostles.
උන්වහන්සේගේ අපොස්තලෝ.
I want you to listen to this.
දැන් මේකට අහුම්කම් දෙන්න.
It's amazing.
ඒක ඉතා පුදුමයි.
That I don't find any recorded healing miracle that Jesus did. After he rose again from the dead, no healing recorded.
Unwanse maranen uttan unata passe kalavu kisima suwakirimak pilibandawa vaartha karala naha.
No healing is recorded.
Kisi suwakirimak vaartha karala naha.
After Jesus rose again from the
dead, Jesus wanse maranen uttan unata passe,
there is no healing that Jesus was involved in.
Jesus wanse suwakirimakata sambandha una kila vaartha vela naha.
He could have healed another blind man, he didn't.
Unwanse thawa andha manushyek suwa karanna thibana namuth kale naha.
He could have healed a deaf man after he rose again from the dead, he didn't.
Marane nuttan unata passe bihiri manushyek suwa karanna thibana ekak kale naha.
I know some of you are listening now.
Dan mandana oba samak ahagena.
He could have made the lame to walk, but he didn't.
Unwanse ta korun naviddawanna thibana namuth unwanse kale naha.
In fact, Jesus could have gone to the gate beautiful and caused that beggar who was paralyzed from his mother's womb to get up.
අතරම කියනවා නම් උන්වහන්සේ සුදර්ශන දොරටුට ගිහිල්ලා මව් කුසේ පඩන්න කොරව මනුෂ්‍යව නැගිටවන්න
දෙපා. Jesus didn't do that.
නමුත් යේසුස් වහන්සේ එක කළේ නැහැ.
Instead,
ඒ වෙනුවට
for 40 days.
අවුරුදු දවස් 40ක්.
He's teaching his apostles.
උන්වහන්සේ අපොස්තලවරුන්ට ඉගැන්නුවා.
He's teaching his apostles.
උන්වහන්සේගේ අපොස්තලවරුන්ට ඉගැන්නුවා.
He's training his men.
උන්වහන්සේගේ මනුෂ්‍යව උන්වහන්සේ පුහුණු කළා.
So that when Jesus ascends,
එවිට යේසුස් වහන්සේ ඉහළට ගියාම
his men will go and use his authority.
මනුෂ්‍යව ගිල උන්වහන්සේගේ ආධිපත්‍ය පාවිච්චි කරන පිණිස.
And they are the ones that went to the gate beautiful.
තමයි සුදර්ශන දොරටුවට ගියේ
and got a lame man to walk
ඒ කොරව මනුෂයා ඇවිද්දේ
who couldn't walk from his mother's womb
අම්මගේ කුසේ සිට ඇවිදින්න බැරි වෙච්ච මනුෂයා
and then you see a stream of the miraculous in the book of acts
ඊට පස්සේ ක්‍රියාපොතේ අපට පේනවා හාස්කම් ගණනාවක්
it's not called the acts of jesus
ඒ කියන්නේ යේසුස් වහන්සේගේ ක්‍රියාකාරකම්
කියලා it's called the acts of the apostles
ඒ කියන්නේ අපොස්තලවරුන්ගේ ක්‍රියා කියලා
it was jesus working through the apostles
ඒ කියන්නේ යේසුස් වහන්සේ අපොස්තලවරුන් හරහා ක්‍රියාත්මක වෙනවා
i want you to understand
මෙන්න මේක ඔබ තේරුම් ගන්න
that god has placed a system like this on this earth.
දෙවියන් වහන්සේ මේ පොළොවේ මේ වගේ ක්‍රමවේදයක් සකස් කරලා තිබෙනවා.
Where you don't necessarily need to ask God to heal you.
ඔබ සැබවින්ම ඉල්ලන්න අවශ්‍ය නැහැ දෙවියන් වහන්සේගෙන් මාව සුව කරන්න කියලා.
Because he has done the work 2000 years ago.
මොකද උන්වහන්සේ අවුරුදු 2000කට කලින් මේ වැඩේ නිම කර තිබෙනවා.
After Jesus finished the work.
යේසුස් වහන්සේ වැඩේ නිම කළාට පස්සේ
he did not heal one person with his hands.
උන්වහන්සේගේ අත්වලින් උන්වහන්සේ කිසිවෙක්ව සුව කළේ නැහැ.
With his physical hands.
උන්වහන්සේගේ භෞතික ශාරීරික අත්වලින්
Now get your head around that.
දැන් ඔබගේ මොළයේ මේක අතුල් කරගන්න.
Instead,
ඒ වෙනුවට
he trained his apostles.
උන්වහන්සේගේ අපොස්තලවරුන්ව පුහුණු කළා.
And he told them, you now go and do the work.
දැන් ඔබ ගිහිල්ලා වැඩේ කරන්න.
Can you see the transfer of authority?
ඔබ මේ ආධිපත්‍ය පරිවර්තනය කරපු ආකාරය?
If now I want to ask you a question.
මම දැන් ඔබගෙන් ප්‍රශ්නයක් අහන්න යනවා.
Listen, this is just a question. I'm not going to give you the answer.
මේක ප්‍රශ්නයක් විතරයි හැබැයි මම උත්තර දෙන්න යන්නේ.
After Jesus rose again from the dead.
යේසුස් වහන්සේ මරණයෙන් උත්තරණය වුණාට පස්සේ
if he did if he chose not to heal even one person
umas ek manushyekwa su nokarannata teendu kalana
instead to sit with his apostles for 40 days and teach them
even what apostle run samaga vaadila dawas 40 ak igannuwa
na how the kingdom of god works
enan deva rajya weda karana aakarya
think a minute with me
mota kitanne gana dan
now jesus has ascended
dan jesus vanse ihila gos tibenawa
do you think he's still interested in laying his hands on somebody
oba itana jesus vanse taama kemathi kela unwasaka atha thaba ayo suwa karanna
oh is he going to do it through his church
ehema natha unwasaka sabha vara unwasaka karanna yanne
see now
dan penawada
bata
dan therunada
man kiyala now you understand the spiritual logic
dan me aathmika tharkaya bata therunawada
jesus is the same yesterday today and forever
jesus vanse iyata sadha kalata meka wage
so in those 40 days after he rose again from the dead if there is no miracle healing recorded that Jesus did after he rose again from the dead then we can come to a conclusion that even after his ascension there is no need for Jesus to stretch his hand and heal anybody
Jesus vanse maranen uttanu unata passe kisivekwa suwakara kiyana vaarthawak naththam meken apata nigamanayakata enna puluwa unwanse ihila naggada passe unwanse awashya naha ekkene ekkana ratha thabasu
karanna because some pray prayers like father stretch your hand and heal
mokada samara ekkena swamine obage haste digukata mawa suwakala manawa kiya
40 days after he rose again from the dead he didn't do it
unwanse dawas 40ak maran negitata passe eka kale
naha now he is ascended
nan unwanse swargata negati benawa
I don't think he'll do it
man hitanne unwanse karai kiya
why wouldn't he do it
ai unwanse karanna
because he's already done it
මොකද උන්වහන්සේ දැනටමත් එක කර තිබෙනවා
there is no reason for him to do anything
උන්වහන්සේට නැවත කිසිවක් කරන්න හේතුවක් නැහැ
please this is the revelation you need to get
මෙන්න මේක තමයි ඔබ ලබා ගත යුතු එළිදරව්ව
that the day Jesus went to the cross
යේසුස් වහන්සේ කුරුසියට ගිය දවසේදී
according to 1 Peter
පළවෙනි පේතෘස්
chapter number 2 verse number 24
දෙවෙනි පරිච්ඡේදයේ 4 වෙනි පදයට අනුව
that he bore my sins in his own body on the tree
උන්වහන්සේගේ ශරීරය මත මාගේ පාපය
that we being dead to sins should live unto righteousness
api paapeta meri dharmishtakamata jeevathana pinisa
by whose stripes ye were healed
unwahasege tuwala verin api suwe laba
sirimu precious ones
anargoba
precious church
anarga sabhava
look at it
me desa balanna
healing is in past tense
me suwe kenek atheetha kaalen tibenne
don't just nod your head receive the revelation
obage oluwa wanan vitarak kapa elitharawu laba ganna
ye were healed
api suwe karunu labuwa huya
notice peter doesn't even include himself in this
බලන්න මේකට පේතෘස්තුමා තමන් අතුලත් කරගන්නෙත් නැහැ
he should have said by whose stripes we were
ඔය කියන්නේ තිබුණා උන්වහන්සේගේ කසපාරවල අපි සුවය ලැබුවා
කියලා he didn't use the word we
ඔව් අපි කියන පදේ පාවිච්චි කරේ නැහැ
including himself
ඔව් අතුල් කරේ නැහැ ඒකට
he used the word ye
ඔව් පාවිච්චි කරේ නුඹලා කියලා
he is only addressing healing to those he was writing to
සුවය ඔව් සුවය අදාළ කරන්නේ ඔව් ලියන අයටයි මේ
because you don't find the apostles sick
මොකද ඔබට හොයන්න බෑ අපොස්තලරුන් ලෙඩ වෙලා සිටියයි කියලා
None of the apostles died of a sickness.
Kisima apostle wariye krogeken miya giye naha.
Are you catching this now?
Ome kala ganawada dan.
Sickness does not belong in the life of a Christian.
Me roga kiyeneka leda kiyeneka kristiyana kritunuwage jeevithara dala naha.
Then prophet why am I like this?
Ena prophet ai mata mehema vela tiyenne.
It's because you have not been taught properly.
Mokada obata eken harita uganwala naha.
And when you catch the revelation it brings elevation.
Oba elithara wima allagattama oba ihala yanawa etenin.
You are a custodian of this.
Oba meke aithikarayek.
You catching this now?
Oba meka allaganna.
So where is the believer's authority?
Ena kohida adilivantege adhipatti metena tibenne.
Notice Jesus for 40 days he's teaching his apostles.
Jesus vanse dina 40ak apostolurata
ganwa. Giving them the authority.
Ounta aadhipathya demen.
To go and do the work.
E weda karana pinisa.
Do you hear this?
Obada meka ahenawada?
Are you hearing this?
Obada meka ahenawada?
Glory to God.
Mahime veva.
There's a point in Acts chapter 4, don't go there.
Kriya 4 wenna parichchede siduwimak
thibena. Where the apostles get together in a place and pray.
Apostoluru ekak sthanata ekathu wela yaachana karana.
And the place shook.
E sthanaya kampane
una. They prayed and said, "Mighty God, stretch forth your hand to heal." Now there's a generic language of scripture.
It's
how we talk.
That
doesn't mean that's the doctrine.
Do
you understand
that?
Differentiate the difference between generic language and the real revelation of healing.
ekena me bhavita bhashave swabhave saha swaye niyama elidaraw oba therum ganna
avashya. We really say, you know, the Lord will heal you today. We say things like
that. Api kiyana swamin wahanse na adanubo swakarai kiyala eka widiyala api kiyana.
We say things like the Lord's hand touches you now.
Swamin wahanse hasthe nubo sparsha karanawa kiyala api kiyana.
That's for those who want to hear such because of their level of maturity.
mokada manushya tamange parinathabhave mattama nisa e wage dewal ahanna
avashya. But as you grow in Christ,
namuth oba Kristus wahanseyala vardhane
wenawa. You come to a place of understanding.
oba therum ganime sthana ekata paminenawa.
That I as a believer I have authority.
mata adilivantayak lesa mata aadhipathyayak thibenawa.
Let me show you a few more things.
man obata thawa karana kiyapak
wenna. James chapter 5 verse 14.
yakob 5:14.
verse 14.
14 weni padaya.
I want to show you something shocking.
mata oba pudumeda patthana deyak.
Is any sick among you?
nubala athara yame krogiva sitida?
Is any sick among you?
nubala athara yame krogiva sitida?
Is any sick among you?
nubala athara yame krogiva sitida?
Is any sick among you?
nubala athara yame krogiva sitinneida?
James doesn't including himself.
Yakob balanna ohu athulath karaganna ekata.
If he included himself, he would have said, is any sick among us?
ohu kiya athulath karagattanaka api athara yame krogiva sitinawa nam.
You see, the apostles had this habit, consciousness, that when it came to sickness, they were not part of it.
mokada me apostolunta avabodayak thibuna un danagena sitiya me roga gana katha karada
ona thulath karagattana
ona eka kotas karanna une
neha. But if there is anyone out there that's sick,
namuth ee bahirawa kenek innawana nam rogiva,
let him call on God.
ohu devan mahase randa gasawa.
That's what James 5:14 says.
anna kai yakob 5:14
kiyanne. Tell me if that's in your Bible.
kiyanne ehema da obage Bible e
kiyanne. If any sick among you, let him call on the Lord.
ona yathrin ame rogiva sinna swamin mahase randa gasawa kiyala
kiyanne. What does it say? What does it say?
mokada ethana kiyanne? mokada ethana kiyanne?
What does it say?
mokada ethana kiyanne?
If any sick among you,
nubala athara yamak rogiva sinna,
let him call on God.
ohu devan mahase randa gasawada?
No.
Nah.
Can you see what I'm talking about? The authority has been transferred. Let him call for the mature ones of the church.
You see what I'm talking
about? This is called the believer's authority. Today, when a Christian is sick, they are calling on God. No problem. Keep calling. Keep doing what you're doing. It's okay. But you're doing it because you are a babe in Christ.
namuth oba eka karanne oba Christus wahanseyala babek nisa.
But as you graduate,
namuth oba vardhane wenawa
vidha, you understand this higher realm of revelation.
me ihala elidarawima oba therum gannawa.
That I have authority.
mata aadhipathyayak thiyenawa.
Jesus has transferred that authority to the church.
Jesus wahanse e aadhipathya sabhawata parivarthane kala
thiyenawa. So if any is sick among you,
e nisa nubala athara yame krogi nam,
call the church.
sabhawata katha karanna.
Hello, are you catching this now?
oba dahanawada meka dan?
Wave your hands if you're getting it.
ab me kala ganna
athara. Call the elders of the church.
sabhave wedimahallanta handa kasawa.
Let them pray over him.
ow kare yaagna karewa.
Anointing him with oil.
owda tel aalepa karawa.
I said to you a few days ago, oil can do nothing for you.
man dawas kipa ekata kalin තෙල් වලින් ඔබට කිසිවක් කරන්න බෑ කියලා.
Oil cannot do anything for you.
තෙල් වලට බෑ ඔබ වෙනුවෙන් කිසිවක් කරන්න.
But how come the oil worked?
එහෙනම් කොහොමද තෙල් වලින් ක්‍රියාත්මක වෙන්නේ?
We had scores and scores and scores of testimonies. How last was it Sunday prophetic night? The ministration of anointing oil healed so many. We are still receiving testimony.
අපට බොහෝ බොහෝ සාක්ෂි ලැබුණා පසුගිය ඉරිදා ප්‍රොපෙතම රාත්‍රියේදී ඒ තෛලයේ ආලේප කිරීම නිසා කොයිතරම් මිනිස්සු සුව ලැබුවාද කියලා.
Even a COVID-19.
COVID-19
රෝගී පවා. We had a testimony.
අපට සාක්ෂි තිබුණා.
Of someone who was diagnosed with COVID-19.
COVID-19 රෝගේ වැළඳුණ කෙනෙක්.
Was participating in the service.
මේ දේවමෙහෙට සහභාගී
වුණා. High fevers. Difficult breathing.
හුස්ම ගන්න අපහසුතාවය.
Breathing was difficult.
හුස්ම ගැනීම ඉතා අපහසු.
Participated in the ministration of the oil.
Yes, Thailand Alapikiri me seve samga sahabaguna.
Next thing you know, in less than 5 minutes.
Minitu paagada taduka.
Breathing returns to normal.
Navata husma gani
paaguna.
Fever
leaves. But I told you who are watching.
Namuth ma obata kiyo balana ayata.
I will not come few days later and sell you oil, COVID-19 oil.
Mama dawas kipekata passe ayilla COVID-19 tel wikunanne neha kiya.
Why?
Aiye.
Because the power is not in the oil.
Mokada balaye tiyenne tel wala nemei.
Is any sick among you?
Nubala athara yame krogi
wesinne. Let him call for the mature ones of the church.
ඔවුන් සභාවෙන් පරිණතයට අඬ ගසාවා.
Let them pray over him.
ඔවුන්ගේ යාඥා කරේවා.
Anointing him with oil.
ඔවුන්ට තෙල් ආලේප කරේවා.
In the name of the Lord.
ඒ ස්වාමින් වහන්සේගේ නාමයෙන්.
So the power in the oil is actually the power of the name of Jesus.
එහෙමනම් ඒ තෙල් වල බලය ඇත්තටම යේසුස් වහන්සේගේ නාමයේ බලයයි.
It's the power in the name of the Lord.
ඒ කියන්නේ ස්වාමින් වහන්සේගේ නාමයේ බලයයි.
In whose name we use oil.
උන් වහන්සේගේ නාමයෙන් තමයි අපි
තෙල් පාවිච්චි කරන්නේ. The oil in itself is useless.
තෙල් ගත්තට පස්සේ කිසි ප්‍රයෝජනයක් නැහැ.
But it's the authority of the name of Jesus.
නමුත් යේසුස් වහන්සේගේ නාමයේ
We are coming back to the authority. Can you see?
ආදිපත්‍යර පේනවනේ.
Is any sick among you?
නුඹලා අතර යමෙක් රෝගී නම්.
Who are they supposed to call?
ඔවුන් කාටද කතා කරන්න අවශ්‍ය වෙන්නේ?
They supposed to call call the Montessori teacher?
Oh, Montessori teacher ta kata karanawa.
Are they supposed to call just someone from somewhere?
Koyari ina taw kaarada kata karanawa?
No, who are they going to call?
Oh, kaarada kata
karanawa. The ones who have authority.
Adipati thina.
Who are the ones who have authority?
Kawuda adipati thina.
The ones who are mature.
Me parinathaya.
Until you are a babe in Christ, you cannot be given authority.
Oba Christus vanthula ladaru ekwa inna taakala obata aadhipathya denna baha.
How many of you have ever cast out a demon?
Obagen kidenek yasuddhatmaya kelawa thibenawada?
Whenever you see a demon, you'll call your pastor, right?
Oba asuddhatmaya dakapu gaman devagathi karata katha karanawa.
Because you have not understood that you have believers authority.
Mokada oba danne ne obata adhilivantayage aadhipathya thibena bawa.
Mark chapter 16.
Mark 16 wenna parichchaya.
So now this is called the system of authority.
Mekata kiyana aadhipathya kramavedaya kiyala.
Go to verse 15. I'm sorry. James chapter 5 verse 15. So you anoint the person with oil in the name of the Lord.
අපි යාකොබ් පහේ 10 වලට යමු. අපි
What happens?
එම ආලේප කරා
මොකද සිද්ධ වෙන්නේ? The prayer of faith shall save the sick.
මේ ඇදහිල්ලේ යාඥාවෙන් රෝගියා ගැලවෙනවා.
But who prayed for them?
එහෙනම් කවුද යාඥා කරන්නේ උන්ට?
Who used their authority?
කවුද ආධිපත්‍ය පාවිච්චි කරන්නේ?
The mature ones of the church.
සභාවේ පරිණත අය.
I want you to hear this well.
මේක හොඳින් අහුම්කම්.
Decide that you're not going to be in kindergarten anymore.
තීරණය කරන්න ඔබ තවදුරටත් ඒ ලදරු පාසලේ ඉන්න යන්නේ නැහැ.
Decide you're going to elevate yourself to a place of maturity.
ඔබ පරිණතභාවයේ ස්ථානයකට ඔබම ඔසවා ගන්නවා කියලා තීන්දුව කරන්න.
The Bible says when you pray that kind of a
Bible
prayer
ekena e wage yaaknayak oba kalaama
not a beggarly prayer
me ayila aayachana karana yaaknayak
you declare things
oba dewal prakash karana
it is done
e sidu
the lord shall raise him up
swamin wasa o nagittawana
who will raise him up
kawuda o nagittawanne
it's jesus
jesus vanse
the lord will raise him up
swamin wasa o nagittawana
because we used his name
mokada unwasage naame api
the lord will raise him up
swamin wasa o nagittawana
because someone used their authority
mokada yam kenek unge aadhipathya paawichchi karapu nisa
you see I want you to understand
menna meka karuna kar therum ganna
if nobody uses their authority on this earth
මේ පොළවේදී කිසිවෙක් ආධිපත්‍ය පාවිච්චි කරේ නැත්නම්
the lord may do nothing on his own
ස්වාමින් වහන්සේ උන්වහන්සේම කිසිවක් කරන්නේ නැහැ
that's why jesus is the head of the church
ඒ නිසා තමයි යේසුස් වහන්සේ සභාවේ හිස කියලා කියන්නේ
and who is the body
එහෙනම් කවුද ශරීරය
we are the body
අපි තමයි ශරීරය
the head cannot do anything without the body
ඒ ශරීරය නැතුව හිසට කිසිවක් කරන්න බෑ
see christians haven't understood this
කිතුනොත් මේක තේරුම් අරන් නැහැ
and the body can't do anything by itself without the head
ශරීරයට කිසිවක් කරන්න බෑ හිස නැතුව
so christ needs listen to me as a child of God you might feel helpless you don't need to be helpless
mokada kithuna ekla obata asarana wage danenna puluwan oba asarana
wiyutu naha listen to me now you are not helpless
oba asarana vela naha
tonight you are going to be given the authority to do something
ada ratriyedi obata yamak karana pinisa aadhipathya
you are not helpless
oba asarana vela naha
you have what is called the believers authority because of what jesus has
jesus wants karapu denisa obata thibena adeelivantaage aadhipathya kiyana eka
remember this The Lord will raise him up.
Swamin vaso nagittawana.
But the Lord will not raise him up until the church uses its authority.
Namo swamin vaso nagittawanne na sabhava ehi aadhipathya paavichcha karata
akka. You getting this revelation?
Obata dan me elithara
wenna ona. Am I you catching this?
Bagen kidena kalla ganna
ona eka. Look at Matthew 10 verse 1.
Matthew 10 palani
padema. This is what Jesus tried to train his apostles to do at the very beginning.
Mulle indalama Jesus vanse meka karana tamai golanna puhunu
karanne. He called his 12 disciples.
Unwanse gola dorasenaata kandewa.
And he gave them power.
Unwanse unta bala දුන්නා
look at that
බලන්න එතන
he gave them power against unclean spirits
අසුද්ධ ආත්මට එරෙහිව බලය දුන්නා
to cast them out
ඔවුන් එළවන පිණිස
he gave them power to heal all manner of sickness and all manner of disease
ආකාරයකම රෝග ලෙඩ සුව කරන්න බලය දුන්නා
I have a question for you
දැන් එහෙනම් මට ප්‍රශ්නයක් තියෙනවා ඔබෙන් අහන්න
how many of you are ready for my question
ඔබගෙන් කීදෙනෙක් ලෑස්තිද මගේ ප්‍රශ්නයට
I have a question for you
මට ඔබට ප්‍රශ්නයක් අහන්න
you
ඔබ
you
ඔබ
oh those days we used to have a gum called you who
අපිට තිබුණා මේ ගම්
you still have it You who are watching me,
me ma balana obata.
I have a question.
Obata prashnayak thiyenawa.
Why would Jesus need to give power to 12 disciples to do something that he himself can do it?
Jesus wahanse etama karanna puluwan deyak karanne ayun wahanse goleyanta balaya dunne ena.
Do you understand this? Why is he giving 12 of his disciples?
උන්වහන්සේගේ ගෝලය දෙනස්තුනට අයුන් වහන්සේ දෙන්නේ
authority. That word power is the word exousia.
ඒ බලය කියන්නේ exousia කියන වචනය.
Which means token of control.
ඒ කියන්නේ පාලනයේ සංකේතය කියලා.
Control means authority.
පාලනය කියලා කියන්නේ ආධිපත්‍යය.
Exousia.
Exousia.
The ability to control a situation.
තත්ත්වයක් පාලනය කරන්න තියෙන හැකියාව.
The ability to control the end result.
මේ අවසාන ප්‍රතිඵලය පාලනය කරන්න
තියෙන හැකියාව. Jesus calls 12 disciples.
යේසුස් වහන්සේ ගෝලය දෙනස්තුනට කතා කළා.
Gives them the authority.
ඔවුන්ට ආධිපත්‍යය දී
to decide what to do with a disease.
ඒ රෝගයක් මොනවද කරන්න
කියලා තීන්දුව ගන්න. What to do with a sickness.
ඒ රෝග වලට මොනවද කරන්න කියලා තීන්දුව ගන්න.
Oh my God.
Hallelujah.
I want to ask you this question again.
එහෙනම් මගේ මේ ප්‍රශ්නේ ඔබගෙන් අහන්න කැමතියි
අපෝ. Isn't Jesus wasting his time?
යේසුස් වහන්සේ කාලේ නාස්ති
කරනවා. By giving authority to 12 disciples.
මේ ගෝලය දෙනස්නාට ආධිපත්‍ය දීලා.
If Jesus was supposed to do it all by himself.
යේසුස් වහන්සේ විසින් මේක කරන්න තිබුණා නම් ගෝලයන්ට බලය දීලා කාලේ නාස්ති කරනව නේද
මේ? Can you see a pattern?
ඔබට තේරෙනවද මේකේ රටාවක් තිබෙනවා? මතේ 10.
Then in Acts 1.
ඊට පස්සේ ක්‍රියා 1.
In James chapter 5.
ඊට පස්සේ යාකොබ් 5.
What is this pattern?
මොකද්ද මේ රටාව?
The pattern is it's always the heart of God the Father to give authority to his kids to stay in control.
එහෙමනම් රටාව තමයි පියවු දෙවියන් වහන්සේගේ කැමැත්ත තමයි හැම වෙලේම උන්වහන්සේගේ දරුවන්ට පාලනය කිරීමේ බලය දෙන එක.
Today the anointing in this service.
අද රාත්‍රියේදී මේ ආලේපය මේ දෙවමේ තියෙන.
Is going to break the shackles of helplessness over people.
ඔය මිනිස්සුන්ගේ තිබෙන ওই අසරණකමේ බාධා කැඩියන්ට යනවා.
People who feel helpless.
අසරණයි කියලා දැනෙන මිනිස්සු.
Oh because of this bad report.
මේ අයහපත් වෛද්‍ය වර්තාව නිසා මං අසරණයි කියලා දැනෙනවා.
You don't need to.
ඔබ වෙන්න නැහැම.
Today you are being informed.
අද ඔබට දැනුම් දෙනවා.
That you have something called the believer's authority.
ඔබට තිබෙනවා මේ ඇදහිලිවන්තයාගේ ආධිපත්‍යය කියන එක.
Mark chapter 16.
Mark 16 වෙනි පරිච්ඡේදය.
Verse 17 and 18.
17 සහ 18 පද.
These signs shall follow them that believe.
ඇදහිලිවන්තයන් කරෙහි මේ ලකුණු අනුගමනය කරනවා.
Are you a believer?
ඔබ ඇදහිලිවන්තයෙක්ද?
These are the believing ones.
මෙන්න මේ තමයි ඇදහිලිවන්තයෝ.
What signs shall follow the believing ones?
මොන වගේ ලකුණුද ඇදහිලිවන්තයන්ගේ පසුපස එන්නේ?
In my name they shall cast out devils.
මාගේ නාමයෙන් ඔවුන් අසුද්ධ ආත්ම එළවන්ට යනවා.
Listen to me.
නහුම් කන් දෙන්න.
You don't need casting out devils is not a spiritual gift.
Me asuddhat melawima kene ka aathmika deemanawak
ne. When I was very immature.
Mama sorry.
When I was very very immature.
Mam bohoma parinata adu kaledi.
I think I was about 19 or 20.
Mama avurudu 19 ak 20 ak tiyedi.
And there was a manifestation of a demon in one person in the church.
Sabaveka manushyekge yam prakashawimak siduna
asuddhat. We had a guest preacher.
Apata hitiya aaradhita deshakek.
And you know the guest preacher called me to a side.
මේ ආරාධිත දේශකයා මට පැත්තක නඩ ගැහුවා
and said to me
මට කිව්වා
I was only 19 20
මම අවුරුදු 19ක් 20ක්
වසිටියා or maybe 21
නැත්නම් 21ක් වෙන්නත්
or maybe 22
22ක් වෙන්නත් පුළුවන්
or maybe even 23
23ක් වෙන්නත් පුළුවන්
but I know for sure
නමුත් අනිවාර්යෙන්ම
මම දන්නවා extremely mature
මම බොහෝම ලදරු අයදී හිටියේ
he told me
ඔව් මට කිව්වා
he said you know Jerome
ඔබ දන්නවද
to cast out demons
මේ වගේ අසුද්ධාත් මෙලවන්න
there are special people
විශේෂ මිනිස්සු ඉන්නවා
so let's leave this to a special person
එනිසා ඒ වගේ විශේෂ කෙනෙකුට අපි මේක ඉර දෙමු
it's called paithyam
ekata kiyanne paithyam kiyala
listen to me
ahun kan denna
mark 16:17
mark 16:17
there's a sign that will follow the believing ones
me adhelivantayanta lakunak thiyena
oun anuwena they will cast out devils
oun yakshan velawanta yanawa
they will speak with new tongues
oun alun ne bhashawen katha karanna
yanawa stop there I want to tell you something
yamak kiyanna ona mata
you know it's funny
hari pudumai
that in the same verse
e ekama padeedi
you have speaking with new tongues
oba alut ba tan dibakin katha karanawa
casting out devils
saha yakshan elawanawa
it's funny how the Christian believes in speaking with tongues
ena hari pudumai kithunanna anya bhashawen katha karana eka vishwasa karanawa
but they feel someone else should cast out the devil
haba etana vena kenek thamai yakshaatma elawanna
if you can speak in new tongues you can cast out devils
amen obata anya bhashawen katha karanna puluwan nam obata yakshan elawanna
puluwan that's what that verse says
eka thamai e padeye kiyanne
do you understand me
obata therunada mawa
you don't need to be specially ordained for this
ekamenin visheshayen aalepa karana avasthawa
these are the benefits that come to you as a child of god
deva daruwek lesa obata labena varaprasadai me
but servants of god will not tell you this
namo deva sevek obata meka kiyanne nathi ve
because they want you to depend on them
mokada ounta avashya oba oun mata yapenawata
because if I didn't teach you this
mokada man obata meka igannuwe naththam
I can continue to show myself as the only person who can cast out that devil
mata pennanna puluwa mata thamai ekama kena yakshaat melawanna puluwan kiya
you understand this
obata therana meka da
But it's a lie.
නමුත් ඒක බොරුවක්.
You have authority.
ඔබට ආධිපත්‍ය තිබෙනවා.
You have authority.
ඔබට ආධිපත්‍ය තිබෙනවා.
Verse number 7:18. Look at verse 18.
18 වෙනි පදේ බලන්න.
They shall take up serpents.
ඔවුන් සර්පයන් අල්ලන්න ඔය.
Now you don't have to literally take up, you know, for those in Sri Lanka, Garandia or some fellow, you know. You don't have to do that.
දැන් ඔබ ගිල්ල අත්තරම මේ ගැරන්ටි එක කරේ මොකෙක් කරේ අල්ලන්න ඕනේ.
You don't have to take up a cobra with your bare hands.
මේ අතින් ගිල්ල නිකන් අයෙක් අල්ලන්න
ඕනේ. That word take up serpents.
මේ සර්පයන් අල්ලන්න ඕනේ
කියන වචනේ. In the Greek it means to locate demonic activity.
ඒ ග්‍රීක වචනේ අර්ථය තමයි මේ අශුද්ධ ක්‍රියාකාරකම් හඳුනා ගන්නවා
කියන්නේ. If they drink any deadly thing.
ඔවුන් ඕනම අශුද්ධ දෙයක් බිව්වොත්
it shall not hurt them.
විෂදයක් බිව්වොත් උන්ට හානියක් වෙන්නේ නැහැ.
Now can you see believers authority?
ඔබට තේරෙනවද අදෙලිවන්තයාගේ ආධිපත්‍යය?
Are you hearing this?
ඔබ අහනවද
මේක? Can you see the authority that you have as a Christian?
ඔබ කිතුනු එක්ලස තිබෙනවා ආධිපත්‍ය ඔබට පේනවාද?
You're worried about dying.
ඔබ මැරෙන එක ගැන බයෙන් ඉන්නවා.
Jesus said if you're a believing one nothing will even hurt you. Forget about dying. I'm going to keep you from hurt.
නමුත් යේසුස් වහන්සේ කියනවා මැරෙන එක අමතක කරන්න ඔබට රිද්දණයෙන් පවා මම
If you are a believing one you will lay hands on the sick and they shall recover.
ඔබ ආධිලිවන්තෙක් නම් ඔබ අත තබනවා ඒ රෝගීන් සුව වෙන්න යනවා.
So tonight.
එනිසා අද රාත්‍රියේදී.
Whoever you are.
ඔබ කවුරු වුණත්.
I want you to lay hands on a loved one.
මං කැමති ඔබ ප්‍රේමණීය
I'm going to train you to use your authority.
මම ඔබ පුහුණු කරන්න යන ඔබගේ ආධිපත්‍යය.
And you're going to send us your testimonies.
ඔබ සාක්ෂි අපට එවන්න යනවා.
As a child of God, you're going to have confidence after tonight.
අද රාත්‍රියෙන් පස්සේ ඔබට ආත්ම විශ්වාසයක්
තියෙනවා. You're not going to be helpless.
ඔබ අසරණ වෙන්න යන්නේ නැහැ.
You can do something about your situation.
ඔබගේ තත්ත්වය ගැන ඔබට යමක් කරන්න පුළුවන්.
Because of Christ.
මොකද ක්‍රිස්තුස් වහන්සේ
නිසා. Because of Jesus.
යේසුස් වහන්සේ නිසා.
Glory to God.
මහිමය වේවා.
Thank you Father.
ස්තුති පියාණනි.
Thank you Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Are you receiving this?
ඔබ මේක ලබා ගන්නවද?
Matthew chapter 15 verse 26
Matthew 15 26
There's a mother that comes to Jesus.
Jesus phansa vetra amma kenek enawa.
And she says, "You know, Lord, please help me. My daughter is grievously tormented with a demon."
Ay kena mata karunakara udaw karanna mage diyaniya bohoma barapatala ashuddha atmaka balapama
kala. You know Jesus doesn't speak to her.
Jesus phansa eta katha karanne.
She goes to the disciples.
Ay golyan langata enawa.
And you know just and the disciples come to Jesus and say Lord do something please do something then Jesus said you know I have not been sent but to the lost sheep of the house of Israel
mama eva tibenne israel hi nathu battleon misa vena kenekuta neme kiya
and then she comes and worships
ඊට පස්සේ යේසුස් වහන්සේව නමස්කාර කරනවා ඇවිල්ලා
and says please help me
කරුණා කර මට උදව් කරන්න
then Jesus said
ඊට පස්සේ යේසුස් වහන්සේ කියනවා
he answered
උන්වහන්සේ උත්තර දෙනවා
it is not good to take children's bread and cast it to dogs
daruwange roti ragena ballanta damima nusudusu kiya unwasa kena
a mother is asking for healing for her daughter
amma ayage duwa wenuen suwe illa sirinawa
what does jesus call healing
mokada jesus wanse suwe ta kiyanne
I want to ask you that question
manga ben ahana oy prashnaya
what does jesus call healing
jesus wanse suwe ta mokak killada metana
kiyanne the mother is asking jesus
amma jesus wanse gen illanne suwe
Please heal my daughter.
Karuna karamage diyeniya suwa karanna.
Jesus said it's not good to take the children's bread.
Yesu wansa karana lamayen daruwange roti aragena
and give it to dogs.
Ballanta deneka sudusu naha
kiyala. So what does Jesus call healing?
Ena Yesu wansa suweta mokadda kiyanne?
Children's bread.
Daruwange roti kiya.
What is healing?
Mokadda suweya?
Children's bread.
Daruwange roti.
Listen to me.
Ahun kan denna meka.
So the key to healing.
Ena suwe sandaha thibena pradhana karana
is to become a child of God.
Deva daruwek wenna ekai mulinma.
Because the bread belongs to children.
Mokadda roti aiti daruwanta.
Are you a child of God?
Oba deva daruwekda?
Then healing belongs to you.
එනං සුවේ ඔබට ආйти.
And if something tries to play funny tricks with your body.
ඔබගේ ශරීරය යම් යම් දේවල් කරන්න පටන් ගත්තොත් එම.
You have to learn how to use your authority.
ඔබ ඉගෙන ගන්න අවශ්‍ය ඔබගේ ආධිපත්‍ය පාවිච්චි කරන්න.
And live in divine health.
ඊට පස්සේ දිව්‍යමය නිරෝගීකමකින් ගමන් කරන්න.
Then you can invite those who don't know Jesus.
ඊට පස්සේ යේසුස් වහන්සේ දන්නේ නැති ඒවා ආලාදනය කරන්න පුළුවන් සුවේ දේවමයට.
But today you're not inviting anybody other than yourself because you're always sick.
මොකද ඔබ දැන් කාටවත් ආරාධනා කරන්න සුවේ දේවමයට මොකද ඔබ හැම වෙලෙම රෝගී වෙන්න නිසා.
But if you activate your authority as
ඔබ දේව අදරු අදෙලිවන්ත එක්ක සාධිපත්‍ය පාවිච්චි කරොත්
you can spend time inviting others
ඔබ අනිත් අයට ආරාධනා කරන
කාලයකට
come
Say thank you Jesus.
Yana stuti Yesu.
Wave your hands to him wherever you are. Activate your faith.
ඔබගේ අදහිල්ල ක්‍රියාත්මක කරන්න.
Healing is the children's bread.
සුවය කියලා කියන්නේ දරුවන්ගේ රොටි.
Become a child of God.
දේව දරුවෙක් බවට පත් වෙන්න.
What else does that statement teach?
එහෙනම් ඒ වගන්තිය තව මොනවද උගන්වන්නේ?
It's children's bread.
දරුවන්ගේ රොටි.
That means healing belongs to a certain class.
ඒ කියන්නේ සුවය කියන එක යම් පන්තියකට අයිති දෙයක්.
Children
daruwa kiyana
bread
daruwan ge roti
I remember one time
man mataka ek kale
ekak I'm in the vehicle
man wahane innawa
and was it you Mikela or Hevenya who wanted to take the money Hevenya are you sure My daughter is in the studio. So, listen. Driving, I have some money. You know, 100 rupee notes. Kept for, you know, those who stop me at the traffic light and knock on the, you know.
Traffic light.
And then I have to put the shutter down and say, God bless you, and give them 100 rupees. So that money was for the beggars. So my daughter, I think Michaela is not telling us the truth. It was Michaela and Hevenya both.
Michaela saha Hevenya dedena.
One day, sitting in the front seat.
Isra seat ekak waadala hitiya.
And I think it was when we were parked at a supermarket, and you know, my wife, their mother, had gone marketing, and when she goes marketing, we know it's going to be a while. We have to have enough of 100 rupee notes. Every beggar that comes. Thank you, sir. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Because one beggar goes and tells another beggar, hey, there's 100 rupee notes coming from that vehicle. Go. So they come. But this particular day, Michaela or Hevenya tried to take money out of that. And said, can I have this? I said, no. I said, that's not your money. That's kept for beggars. Your money is kept somewhere else. The same applies to what Jesus said. This bread belongs to children. Do you understand what I'm talking about? When it comes to divine healing, when it comes to divine healing, in health, when it comes to a victorious life, it belongs to a certain category of believers. And understand that if you're watching me now and you're under the influence of my voice, you are part of that. You are a child of God. You are not supposed to be helpless. You don't need to die like your mother. You don't need to suffer like your grandfather. Jesus has consummated salvation on the cross. Jesus is the perfect sacrifice. God is not mad with you. He is not mad at you. He is mad about you. He loves you. He is not angry with you. He's like one of my minister friends. He's got your photograph in his wallet right now. He's madly in love with you. He's not the one condemning you. He's not even the one convicting you. He's the one comforting you. He wants you to know tonight the truth of the gospel. Why do you need to suffer when a man suffered? When he took upon his body all my sins, why are you still living in sin? Get into this revelation that Christ Jesus has suffered. Christ Jesus is God's perfect sacrifice. Christ Jesus has paid for my sin and my sickness. I don't need to live a single day in sickness.
Mama roge tu lekka davasakkat gatha karanna avashya
naha. Your body may fight you now and again.
Obage shaririya dansa nawatha
taragara battawa. But you use your believer's authority.
Namuth obage aadhipathya oba pawichcha karanna na
deeya. Are you a child of God?
Oba deva daruwekda?
Are you listening to this? You know, have you noticed I'm teaching a little extra than other days? Why is that? Because that's what the Lord is calling me to do tonight. Are you a child of God? The Bible says in Romans chapter
8,
verse number 16, because the key to a believer's authority is, you don't just be a believer, you have to be a child of God. How do you know you're a child of God? You have what is called a witness and evidence in your spirit. The Spirit Himself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. Romans 8:16. The Spirit Himself, the Holy Spirit, who dwells inside us, gives us that evidence. You are a child of God. 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 Then healing is the child's bread. It belongs to you. Book of Galatians, final scripture. How do I become a child of God? Galatians 3:26-27. Are you listening to this? How do I become a child of God? Galatians 3:26. For ye are all the children of God by faith in Christ Jesus. Now,
then,
I hope you have received this message with your heart. You have authority. You can do something about the helpless situation. Because you are a child of God. When did you become a child of God? We are all children of God by faith in Christ Jesus. Listen to me. Have you put your faith in Christ Jesus? If you do that, that is the day you legally become a child of God.
And
as a child of God, healing is your bread. It belongs to you. It's yours. You don't have to beg for it. Today I was in the boardroom. You know, we have a nice boardroom here. And before the service, I get in there. And I have my glass of water and certain things I have there. Biscuits, grape, you know, all of that. My glass. And then my daughter walks in unannounced. She walks in unannounced. As you know, like a wrestler. Just
wrestler.
No knocking, nothing. Breaking all protocols. Walks in. Takes the glass. Drinks. And says, "Dad, I'm having your..." Didn't ask. She knew her rights and her authority as a child. I'm here to tell you tonight. The Lord is okay in you breaking protocol as a child of God. Tonight, you can say, "Father, I take it. Father, I refuse to allow my loved one to be sick like this. I'm a child of God. I'm using my authority today. I don't need to be helpless. Jesus has given me authority. There's a system of authority. I have the token of control. I said this before we minister. Listen to me. Listen to me. Write this down. Power flows through authority. As electricity flows through wires. This is an important key. There can be power. But what good is power if you don't have the right to use it? Did you catch what I just said? What good is power if you don't have the right to use it? That's why Jesus gave the church authority. The power is available. Jesus is God's perfect sacrifice. Jesus is perfect theology. Jesus has done everything he needed to do for you to receive. Power is available, but it flows through authority. Do you hear what I'm talking about? Think of a policeman that has the power, but it's useless if the authority doesn't give him authority. He'll be just standing by the roadside, having the power to do something, but he has not been given the authority. Have you not seen a lot of traffic on the road? And then, you know, while you are in the traffic, There's a policeman that comes in his motorbike.
Police nala dare ekena hoge motorbike kare.
And he parks next to you.
Oh, obata haya patte nawattana.
And you look at him.
Oh, bohudiya balanawa.
And you're saying you want to say, "Sir, can't you do something about all this traffic?"
Obata me traffic ekena monawath karanna bayida?
You know why he doesn't do anything?
මොකද ඔය පුකුත් කරන්නේ නැත්තේ?
He has the power.
ඔහුට බලය තියෙනවා.
But he doesn't have authority.
නමුත් ඒ ආධිපත්‍ය ඔහුට නැහැ.
There's something about prophets.
මේ දිවසුරන් ගැන යමක් තිබෙනවා.
When God gives you a prophet.
දෙවියන් වහන්සේ ඔබට දිවසවරයෙක් දුන්න
විට. There is an authority a prophet carries.
දිවසවරයෙක් ළඟ තිබෙනවා ආධිපත්‍යයක් තිබෙනවා.
That's very unique and special.
ඒක ඉතාම අනන්‍ය සුවිශේෂයක්.
It's a territorial authority.
ඒක වෙල්ල ප්‍රාදේශීය ආධිපත්‍යයක්.
Right now this entire territory knows I'm here now.
දැන් මේ මුළු වාතාවරණයම දන්නා මා මේ ස්ථානයේ සිටින බව.
There is a territorial grace.
මේ යම් ප්‍රාදේශීය අනුග්‍රහයක් තිබෙනවා.
How did we cross 1000 global church members in such a short period of time?
කෙටි කාලයක් තුල ගෝලීය සභාවේ 1000ක්
මෙවුවේ. Because there's a territorial authority.
ඒ කියන්නේ යම් ප්‍රාදේශීය ආධිපත්‍යයක් තිබෙනවා.
Are you hearing this?
ඔබට මේක ඇහෙනවද?
Now as a believer.
දැන් ඇදහිලිවන්තෙක් ලෙස.
You may not need to focus on territorial authority.
ඔබ මේ ප්‍රාදේශීය ආධිපත්‍ය ගැන අවධානය යොමු කරන්න අවශ්‍ය නැහැ.
Just focus on your authority over your own family.
ඔබගේම පවුල කරේ ඔබගේ ආධිපත්‍ය ගැන අවධානය යොමු කරන්න.
Even if your dog is sick today
obage balla ada rogi ve innwana
you can pray
obade yakna karanna puluwa
I don't know why I said that
man danna ayek kiwa kiya
but I just wanted to throw that in
namuth mata eka obade denna awashyai
free of charge
nomile
you can use your authority
obade puluweni obage aadhipathya
in a moment I'm going to show you how to do it
mohothakin ma obade pennanne
say these words after me
me wachana ma samaga kiyanna
power flows through authority
බලය ගලා යන්නේ
like
ආධිපත්‍ය හරහා
flows through wires
හරියට විදුලි බලය වයර් හරහා ගලාගෙන යනවා
lift your hands
ඔබගේ අත ඔසවන්න
pray this prayer with me
මේ යාඥාව මා සමග කියන්න
I put my faith in Christ Jesus
මාගේ ඇදහිල්ල මා ක්‍රිස්තුස් යේසුස් වහන්සේ කෙරෙහි තබනවා
and his finished works
සා උන්වහන්සේගේ නිමා කළ වැඩ කෙරෙහි
Jesus is perfect sacrifice
යේසුස් වහන්සේ තමයි අංග සම්පූර්ණ පූජාව
perfect theology
අංග සම්පූර්ණ දේව ධර්ම
I acknowledge
මම පිළිගන්නවා
I don't need to add anything
මට කිසිවක් එකතු කරන්න අවශ්‍ය
නැහැ or remove anything
සා කිසිවක් ඉවත් කරන්න
ඕනේ නැහැ Jesus is more than enough.
Jesus vanse onota tara pramanavat.
I believe.
Mam vishwas karanawa.
Jesus is risen from the dead.
Jesus vanse marnane uttanu
ubawa. He has ascended.
Un vanse ihila naga thibenawa.
And he is seated at the right hand of God the Father.
Devan vansege piyu devan vansege dakunu pasa waadi wisirnawa.
I love Jesus.
Mama Jesus vanse ta adare.
I put my faith in Christ.
Mage adeilla mam Christus vanse pat tabanawa.
And now I invite the Holy Spirit.
Dan mama shuddhatmana vansata aaradhana karanawa.
To take his abode in my body.
Mage sharire thul unwanse vaase karana
pirisa. And bring every physical organ in alignment.
Mage ම ශාරීරික අවයක්ම හරියට පෙළගස්වන ලෙස
because I believe
මොකද මම විශ්වාස කරනවා
that as a child of god
දේව දරුවෙක් ලෙස
and a believer
ඒ වගේම ඇදහිලිවන්තයෙක් ලෙස
that I have been given authority
මට ආධිපත්‍ය ලබා දී තිබෙනවා
and I use that authority tonight
ඒ ආධිපත්‍ය මම අද පාවිච්චි කරනවා
and speak to every ailing part of my body
මගේ ශරීරයේ සෑම රෝගී තැනකට මම කතා කරනවා
by placing my hand
මගේ අත තබමින්
I command this disease
මම අණ කරනවා මේ
රෝගයට I command this pain
මේ වේදනාවට මම අණ කරනවා
I command this disorder
මේ අපිලිවලට මම අණ කරනවා
I command this swelling
මේ ඉදීමීමට මම අණ කරනවා
I command this pain
මේ වේදනාවට මම අණ කරනවා
I command this bone
මේ අස්ථි වලට මම අණ කරනවා
I command this shortened breath
මේ හුස්ම හතියට මම අණ කරනවා
I command the shortened muscle or the deteriorating muscles
මේ ෂය වෙනා වූ මස්පිඩි වලට මම අණ කරනවා
bones that are shorter than another
අනිත් එකට වඩා කොට වෙලා තියෙන අස්ථි වලට මම අණ
කරනවා every hereditary sickness
මේ සෑම රෝගයකටම
every sickness coming through the bloodline
මේ ලේවලින් එනා වූ ලේ පරම්පරාවට
සෑම රෝගයක්ම every issue with the eyes
absolute same prashnayak
every issue with the throat
ugure same prashnayak
every sickness to do with the ears
me kangha sambandha same rogayak
anything to do with the eyes
assa sambandha ona
anything to do with the spine
me kondu ada periya sambandha
anything to do with the kidneys
me wakagoda sambandha ona
the liver
akmava
the pancreas
me agnyashaya
I take authority over it
agare adhipathya
as a child of god
deva daruwek lesa
I thank you father for the power of god
piyanani devyan vasage balane
and the authority that I have
e wage mata thina adhipathya
I refuse to be helpless.
Mama asarane vima pratikshepa karana.
I refuse to be helpless.
Mama asarane vima pratikshepa.
Begin to pray, begin to pray, begin to pray. Say I refuse to be helpless.
Mama asarane vima pratikshepa
karana. I'm a child of God.
Mama deva daruwe.
I refuse to be helpless.
Mama asarane vima pratikshepa karana.
I'm a child of God.
Mama deva daruwe.
I refuse to be helpless.
Mama pratikshepa karana asarane vima.
So in Jesus name.
Jesus vansage namen.
I command all these symptoms to leave.
Me sama roga lakshana ekata ivat wenna ana karana.
I command the diagnosis to change.
Me swagata rogeta wenas wenna ana karana.
I command the lumps to vanish.
Mama gedi walata ivat wenna ana karana.
My child's asthma to be healed
mage daruwage adumata suwa wenna ana karanawa
eyesight be restored
me aspenima nawatha pratisthapana karanawa
young children under 7 years of age that are wearing specs be healed by the power of god
hatata adu kannada dana daruwan suwa labana
in the name of jesus
jesus vansage namen
in the name of jesus
jesus vansage namen
say I use my authority
kiyana mama mage adhipathya pawichchi karanawa
and I come command every foul spirit.
Sam asudhaatmaya man
angana. Every spirit of failure.
Sam asaarthaka aathmaya
karana. Every spirit of disease.
Sam roga athi karana aathmaya.
Every spirit of infirmity.
Sam dubalata athi karana.
Every generational curse.
Sam parampara shaapaya
karana. By the authority that Christ has given me.
Christ vaase maradila thina aadhipathya anuwa.
I break it now in the name of Jesus.
Kala damana Jesus vaase ka naame.
Hallelujah to the Lamb.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I break it now in the name of Jesus.
Maa Jesus vaase ka naame kala damana.
Every cycle of failure.
Sam asaarthakana chakra
financial paralysis
mulyame adubalatavayan
by the authority I have in Christ Jesus
sansathara dinama aadhipathya karana kodagena
I break it now in Jesus name
manna ega khada damana Jesus
vaase as Goliath's neck was cut
Goliath ge bella kapuwa wage
so that Goliath will never rise again
Goliath navata nanakitrana pinisa
I use the sword of my mouth
mage mukaye kaduwa man pavichchi karana
the rema of God
devan vaasage rema
and I say to the sickness
e rogeta mama kiyana
I say to the poverty
e duppatkamata mama kiyana
I say to that bad report
e ahapat vaarthawa
mama kiyana I say to that cancer
e pilikawata mama kiyana
I say to that infection
e aasadaneta mama kiyana
I cut your head in the name of Jesus you will not rise again you will not rise again you will not disturb me again no more cancer no more cancer no more tumors no more disease Jesus is perfect sacrifice Jesus is perfect theology as Goliath's head was cut so is this sickness today so is this disease today So is this skill ailment today.
May rogi tatya tesemai ada.
In the name of Jesus.
Jesus vaasage naame.
Say it again as a child of God.
Deva daruwak lesa navatha kiyanna.
I use my authority now.
Mama mage aadhipathya dan pavichchi karanawa.
Every lump in the breast dissolve, disappear, dematerialize and get out in the name of Jesus.
Piyuru wala thiyana sama gediyakma vinashala diya vela ivat wenu.
Everything related to the spine go now in Jesus.
Kodudaradiya sambandha sama deyakma ivat wenu dan Jesus.
I release the healing power of God.
Devan vaasage suye balaye ma
Into your bodies,
obage sharira walata,
into your nervous system,
obage snayu paddhatiyata,
every infirmity in the nervous system,
sama dubalatavayakma snayu paddhatiye,
every issue with the nervous system,
snayu paddhatiye sambandha sama prashnayakma obage snayu
wala, certain body parts that are not functioning,
yam yam sharira avayava harira kriyaatmaka
wenna, your right hand is immobile,
obage dakunu hata chalane karanna baha,
your feet, your toes, you can't move, you can't feel sensation,
obage patule hangim danim naha obata danenna,
right now be healed in Jesus name,
Jesus vaase namen suya labanna
By the authority Christ has given
Christ
his church.
Christ vaase unwasake sabhavala dina tin aadhipathya karana kota gana.
We command normalcy to you.
Obata samanya tatte api ana karana.
In the name of Jesus.
Jesus vaase ke naame.
Somebody shout hallelujah if you can.
Kyan hallelujah kyan hallelujah.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah hallelujah.
Now listen.
Danga hun kan denna.
Precious ones.
Anarkoba.
Precious ones. Authority you have to use your mouth
aadhipathya kelana obbe mukaye pawichchi karanna awashya
you have to use your mouth when it comes to using your authority
obbe aadhipathya gana katha karaddi obbe mukaye obbe pawichchi karanna
awashya even a policeman blows a whistle
police nadarek unath whistle ekak ganawa
what are you doing
obbe mukadda karanne
you know authority is not just lifting your hands
aadhipathya kelana atta samakatarak neme ekanga vima etarak
neme use your mouth
obbe mukaye pawichchi karanna
use your mouth
obbe mukaye pawichchi karanna
place your hand on your heart
obbe hadawata atha thaba ganna
right now right then, now then, right then, now place then. Your hand on your heart
obbe hadawata atha thaba ganna
use your authority
aadhipathya pawichchi karanna
understand you are a child of god
obbe deva daruwek bawa therum ganna
and I'm going to give you 5 minutes
man obbe minutu 5k denna yanawa
begin to pray yourself
obbama yaakna karanna padan ganna
command every report to change
sama vaarthawaka wenas wenna ana karanna
begin to speak over your family
obbage paula karee katha karanna
begin to speak over any ailment in your body
obbage sharire oonama tattayak gana katha karanna
do it now
dan karanna dan karanna
over your passport
obbage passport
over anything that concerns you
obba sambandha oonama
de you are not helpless
oba asarana vela neha
you are receiving the token of control
oba e balaye lakuna laba gannawa
you have the authority to make changes
obata wenas athikara athikaranna aadhipathya
if you are financially down
oba mooliyame washen
pahata I want you to take some money
oba yam mudalak ganna
place it before you
eka oba idire thaba ganna
and I want you to speak to it
oba ekata katha karanna
do you hear what I'm saying
obata ayanada ma
if you're financially paralyzed
oba mooliyame washen dubala ila
get some money
yam mudalak ganna
put it in front of you
eka oba idire thaba ganna
begin to speak to it
ekata katha karanna padan ganna
Precious church
anarga sabhava
I'm giving you 5 minutes now
mangobada minute 5k denawa
worship the lord with pastor
swami vasa namaskara gana pastor
sing that song be magnified o lord
hallelujah
be magnified o lord
hallelujah
be magnified o lord
hallelujah
as pastor pio sings for 5 minutes
pastor pio minute 5k
I want the congregation to pray.
I've
given you the keys.
Now
don't waste time. Begin to pray. This is your turn. This is your time. This is your time. Get that family photograph. Use your authority. Say, there shall not be premature death in my family. Do what you have to do now. And I want you to see with your spiritual eyes. Goliath had been cut. Goliath was never able to rise again. That sword is your mouth today. Use it.
Prophet Jerome, more than just words.